And it's the first race I'm bringing you here. It's day three on the National Hunt, and it's the Potemps Handicap Hurdle Qualifier. Equator, Paul Rhodes, Westwire, Russian, Achern, Byrne for Martin Leedham, Billy Vodden, Tapper, Thomas Rogers, Bell Kennan, Alex Cherry, Eaton Mess, Ryan Tamasebi, Ring of Esteem, Thomas Rogers, Sir Gerard, David Hooley, World on Fire, Joshua Sutherland, Mercury Rising, Craig Beckwith. We've got Mighty Black and Pontypool Racing for Graham Clutterbuck, Climbing Shadows, Craig Beckwith, Hazel Rig Hawker for Dee Thompson, Ernest Dravinsky, Paul Rhodes, Redwood Edition, David Robertson, and Segretezza, Lexi, and Resentful Sadie complete the lineup for James Shea. And they're off and running. And it's incredible what difference a bit of sunshine can make, because yesterday we were racing on bottomless ground here at Exeter, and today we're on much quicker. Good is the official go in here. So the racecourse clerks have done a great job of draining some of the water off the track, assisted by this glorious sunshine and much different conditions to what some of these trainers were perhaps expecting when leaving the race course yesterday. But we've got Equator in the early lead for Paul Rhodes, has opened up a really decent gap already, but a long way to go, so I don't take too much notice of who's that front runner and how big the gap is so early on in a 3 mile race. But Equator does have the lead from two horses in the purple silks, although they are for different trainers. So familiarize yourself with Sir Gerard on the rail, the lighter bay horse, that's David Hooley's, and towards the middle of the track, Westwire Rush is one of my fellow commentators' horses in this race, that's Martin Leedham. That one's racing on the inside of another one of Paul Rhodes' horse, that's Ernest Dravinsky. And racing towards the rail and just in behind Sir Gerard, we have Climbing Shadows as they start to swing right-handed. You can see the grey horse there at the beginning, at the front of the chasing pack. That's Hazel Rig Hawker. And on the inside of that one, we've got Mighty Black. Just in behind those, we've got Achern Byrne. And that one's running alongside Mercury Rising towards the rear of the field at the moment. The back marker is the one from my stable today. That's Eaton Mess. Only one runner in the race for me, and that one's just racing in behind the two James Shea horses. Oh, we've lost one of those James Shea horses. Segretezza Lexi got it all wrong and fell. And that means that his only remaining runner in this race is Resentful Sadie, who you can see is towards the rear of the field in the all green silks, racing on the rail in front of Ring of Esteem and Eaton Mess. But heading back towards the front of the field, and it's still Equator in the lead in those green and yellow silks for Paul Rhodes. A few lengths still to Westwire Rush and Hazel Rig Hawker, who are racing in second and third as they come past what will be the winning post in a circuit's time. And towards the rail, you can see they're Climbing Shadows, Achern Byrne, the black horse, Sir Gerard hugging the rail and looking to travel the least amount of distance possible and make sure it's got that maximum finish in it at the end of the race for David Hooley. So Equator's in the lead, and I know David quite fancies Sir Gerard at the weights in this handicap hurdle, so it'll be interesting to see how that one fares. As we look towards the rear of the field, Ring of Steam is now your back marker, as Eaton Mess and Resentful Sadie have moved a little bit further forward. Good jump there at the back from Bell Kennan allowed that one to move forward and get closer into that chasing pack. But as we go back to the front of the field, you can see that whilst Equator's still in the lead, it's Joshua Sutherland's World on Fire that's now the closest pursuer. But as no sooner have I said that, the jockey started to rein that one back in and let it get a little bit of cover again. In behind Hazel Rig Hawker, Climbing Shadows and Mighty Black. And nearest to the camera here, you can see Cuddly Cord is racing alongside Ernest Stravinsky, but they are towards the rear of the field at the moment. So a few horses are racing quite wide just to avoid getting stuck in behind any horses as the race starts to unfold, perhaps looking to avoid any potential incidents as we have many more flights of hurdles left to jump. So as they start climbing up this hill here at Exeter, it's still Equator in the lead. Good couple of lengths back still. That's been the gap between first and the chasing pack since the tapes went up, really. So it's Equator still a few lengths from Mighty Black now, the new horse to take up second position from Resentful Sadie. That's closer than it's ever been so far. And just looking towards the rear of the field, we still have Ring of Esteem and Billy Vodden Tapper towards the rear. Other than losing Segretet's Alexi, all of the horses have jumped pretty well so far, and Eaton Mess now is closer than it's ever been and moving forward into third place alongside Sir Gerard. So those two horses are creeping ever closer, but as is Hazel Rig Hawker, who's now closest to Equator and perhaps going to join that one in the lead. The jockey on Equator just pushing it along there, wants to try and maintain that advantage as they come into the next flight of hurdles. Good jump from all of those at the front, not particularly fluent at the back from Billy Vodden Tapper and Ernest Ravinsky, who was ridden out of the other side. The other runner for Paul Rhodes wants that one to get a little bit closer. But Paul Rhodes still has the lead with Equator. Hazel Rig Hawker in Eaton Mess and Sir Gerard perhaps all travelling more strongly than it though, just in behind. Looking back for the chase impact, World on Fire still catching my eye, is travelling really strongly, as is Redwood Edition. James Shea might have lost Segretet's Alexi, but look at Resentful Sadie. It's just weaved its way through a few horses there on the rail and is now the leader as we go into the final four furlongs. Resentful Sadie has the lead from Eaton Mess. I think Equator might have run its race after setting the pace for this whole way, and I said World on Fire was one to watch as we were about five furlongs from home, as three furlongs from home. It's now travelled powerfully into this race and looks the main danger to Resentful Sadie, but there's still over two furlongs left to go. Resentful Sadie jumped it really well and still has a gap of a few lengths, but World on Fire is trying to close that gap. Eaton Mess took off a little bit early at that flight and didn't make the progress it wanted to, and actually the dangers now look like it might be Redwood Edition, Hazel Rig Hawker and Sir Gerard. But as you can see, World on Fire now has the lead, and Resentful Sadie gave that up quite tamely as we go towards the final half of furlong. World on Fire is in the lead, Redwood Edition's trying to chase it down, but nothing's going to catch this as we come towards the winning post and pass it. World on Fire wins it comfortably for Joshua Sutherland in the black and red silks there. It's another winner over the jumps for one of the top jumps trainers. He'll be delighted with that run, travelled powerfully throughout the race and picked off that leader as we approached the last flight and stayed on powerfully to win. World on Fire wins it at some very, very big odds for such a good, prolific trainer over the jumps, Joshua Sutherland. Redwood Edition, one of the shorter prices, stayed on really well to take second place for Davy Ladd. Sir Gerard ran well, placed in the top three there for David Hooley. Hazel Rig Hawker fifth for Dee Thompson. Bell Kennan completes your top five for Alex Cherry.